This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We're going to be deriving the cofunction identities in this video. There are six of them. But first of all, what are cofunctions? The sine and cosine are cofunctions. The tangent and cotangent are said to be cofunctions. And the secant and cosecant are considered to be cofunctions. So first of all, you have to know what a cofunction is. Before deriving them, let's just look back at what happens in a right triangle if you're trying to find the cosine and sine for the acute angles. First of all, what do we call this angle over here? If one angle is called x, we know that x plus that other angle adds up to 90 degrees, or if we want to use radians, it would be pi over 2. So the other angle would be pi over 2 minus x. That's what you get when you subtract x from both sides of that equation. So I'm going to call this other angle in here pi over 2 minus x. Okay, so we have the right angle, we have an angle x, and we have the angle pi over 2 minus x. So if we look at this picture here, note that the cosine of x would be adjacent over hypotenuse, that would be a over c. And then if I want to take the sine of this other angle, pi over 2 minus x, that's the opposite over hypotenuse, that's also a over c. So this is telling us that the sine of pi over 2 minus x is actually the same thing as the cosine of x. Similarly, you can see that the cosine of x, pi over 2 minus x, is going to be the same thing as the sine of x, and that the tangent of pi over 2 minus x equals the cotangent of x, etc. You could also do this for the secant and the cosecant. The secant of pi over 2 minus x equals the cosecant of x. In other words, you can go through and figure out each of these and notice that these are actually true equations. But this is true in a right triangle where x is an acute angle. What we're going to do now is show that it doesn't have to be an acute angle to get these identities here. These are four of the six identities that we call the cofunction identities. So this is what we're working toward. There are going to be six cofunction identities. It's easy to verify these for an acute angle, like we just did. And the cofunction identities simply state that the value of any trigonometric function at x, all right, so whatever number you want for x or angle you want for x, it's the same thing as the value of the cofunction at pi over 2 minus x. So we're going to take one of them that we just figured out, the cosine of pi over 2 minus x. We think it's supposed to be the sine of x, right? So we're going to use the formula for the cosine of a difference right up here. So we want the cosine of the first angle, cosine of pi over 2 times the cosine of the second angle, which is x. And then that'll be a plus the sine of the first angle, which is pi over 2 times the sine of x in this case. Now remember, cosine of pi over 2 and sine of pi over 2 are just numbers. I always think about where that is on the unit circle. That's the order pair 0, 1 here up at pi over 2. So the first coordinate is the cosine, the second coordinate is the sine. So this tells me that the cosine of pi over 2 is 0. So I'm going to say this is simply 0 times the cosine of x, plus, and the sine of pi over 2 is 1, and that's times the sine of x. So I have 0 times cosine of x, that's 0 plus sine x, right? 0 plus the sine of x, which is simply the sine of x. So I've shown that it didn't really matter what x was. It could be any number. It doesn't have to be an acute angle, and I've got the first cofunction identity, the cosine of pi over 2 minus x, is the same thing as sine of x. Now we could do a cool substitution to come up with the other identity, which is that the sine of pi over 2 minus x is the cosine of x. So let's see how that works. I'm going to write it as the cosine of pi over 2 minus u equals the sine of u. Remember, it just means what, this angle is the same or this number is the same, u, right? You can put x and x, you can put a and a, b and b, whatever you want. I'm going to let x equal pi over 2 minus u. Now let's solve that for u. So I would add u to both sides and subtract x. That would give me u is the same thing as pi over 2 minus x. So what I'm going to do, in place of pi over 2 minus u, I'm going to put x, and in place of u, I'm going to put pi over 2 minus x. So this is what that looks like. Cosine of, all right, pi over 2 minus u is what I called x, and u, that's pi over 2 minus x. So now I've got my second cofunction identity. All right, so we established that the cosine of pi over 2 minus x is sine of x. The sine of pi over 2 minus x is cosine of x. How about the tangent? We know tangent is of an angle or a number is the same thing as the sine of that divided by the cosine. So that's the sine of pi over 2 minus x all over the cosine of pi over 2 minus x. But we look up here and we see that the sine of pi over 2 minus x is the same thing as the cosine of x. And the cosine of pi over 2 minus x is simply the sine of x. And cosine over sine is the cotangent of x. That's our third identity. So we've got the cosine of pi over 2 minus x is sine of x, sine of pi over 2 minus x is cosine of x, and now we've got that the tangent of pi over 2 minus x equals to cotangent of x. What if we wanted to know what the cotangent of pi over 2 minus x is? Well, we could use the same reasoning. We could say, well, that's just the cosine of pi over 2 minus x over the sine of pi over 2 minus x. But that gives us the sine of x over the cosine of x, which is the tangent of x. All right, there's our fourth one. All right, so we've done four of them so far. How would we do the cosecant of pi over 2 minus x? Any ideas? Well, we know that's the reciprocal function. So of sine, so that's 1 over the sine of pi over 2 minus x. But what is the sine of pi over 2 minus x? Look up here. That's the cosine of x. And again, the reciprocal function here, 1 over cosine of x, is the same thing as the secant of x. There's our fifth one. One more to go. Let's see if you could do it. Put the video on pause. See if you can do secant of pi over 2 minus x. Okay, I'm hoping you put it on pause and tried it on your own. So let's see. That's the same thing as 1 over the cosine of pi over 2 minus x. And looking up here, we see the cosine of pi over 2 minus x is sine x, so that's 1 over the sine of x. And that, well, 1 over sine of x, the reciprocal function, would be cosecant of x. And finally, we actually have all six of the cofunction identities now. All right, so here we are. These are the six cofunction identities, and anytime you see the cosine of pi over 2 minus x, you know that you can simply state that that's the sine of x. So if you knew what the sine of x is, you wouldn't have to go and use the difference formula, for instance. Be a good idea to try all these on your own. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.